Well, I'm back with this project, and maybe if you remember, well, it shouldn't be hard to remember because it was like a few seconds ago for you. But this was the Polynesian style bowl. I decided it's too much of a. Yeah, well, it's too much. It doesn't work. Gonna try it again with another bowl. I'm not giving up on the idea, but this bowl is just getting smaller and smaller. So I'm gonna try something else. I turned everything away, so it was about, well, I think 3 millimeters. So it's a lot of wood that I had to take off. But I've decided to do something else, and don't know if this is gonna work either, but at least it will be easier to sand off because it's paint. And what I've got here is, yeah, how can I let you see that? Well, like this. This is acrylic. Oops. Oh, I'm. Blop. Acrylic pearl metallic paint. I use this. For mural paintings that I do occasionally, well, once, but that's occasionally, I think. And I'm gonna just, nothing fancy, just put it on. I will cover the whole thing with it. And I've made lines in it again. And my ID, because it's not sanded yet. At all, I just turned and did my final ish cut. So there's this bowl has a lot of end grain here, and I'm just gonna be putting this on. And the idea of it is to sand it off, sand with the sandpaper. We'll see what happens. I don't know. You can see I've sanded it all the way down, and I don't know if I can show you, but I hope you can see the metallic shine in the rims. We'll put you back. So the next thing I want to do, because all the grain, the deeper grain, has the bronze in it, and I've sanded it to, let's see, 240, sorry. I sanded it to 240 grit, and it's very smooth. It can be much smoother, but I sanded it because I'm gonna get it another paint coat with bronze and gold. Kind of a blending technique. I use it for paintings too. I'm using this. It's a very small brush with very long hair, so it's flexible. It's easier than the regular paintbrush. This is more for very much more like details. Like at the bottom. And this is a very, very good way to blend. It is a synthetic fiber. And I'm quite happy, I think, with how it's gonna look. Some of the details are easier with this, so dripping, there's not much dripping, but it's easier. I don't know, it's hard for you to, it's hard to see in this light, I think. There will be more sanding, of course, at the end. I'm gonna sand it up to probably 800 grit, 800 or 1000, because I'm planning on finishing it off with shallow wax cream. Gonna put on sanding sealer on top of the coat of paint. And it will probably take off a bit from the paint, I think. I never done it before, but I just want to seal the paint. And it doesn't matter if it takes off a bit of the paint. I don't care. Goes much easier than on plain wood. Usually doesn't work that. Gonna use the shallow wax cream. Last few times I used this, I didn't really get the shine that it should be, but I've read that maybe I've just didn't sand it enough or didn't did something wrong. I don't know. Probably, very, very probably, possibly. And I think I've put it on way too much by now. But yeah, but that's a but. Anyway. Try and do this. I've sanded the inside to 1000 grit, but I've got new sandpaper discs. It has a name, the special ones, the something with aluminum oxide, blah blah blah. But I have a feeling the grain is a bit of the grit is a bit different than what I'm used to. But gonna skip the Yorkshire grit normal because it's so high already. So gonna do this now. And to finish it off, I'm gonna use Hampshire Sheen High Gloss. I like the way it smells. I like the way it smells. So, cut it off the lathe. Look at the shine in this thing. That's a Hampshire Sheen High Gloss. On the outside is Shallow Wax. Hope I can show you this insane metallic details. I'm happy with it. It should be a Polynesian style ball, but in the end it's, I don't know how to call it yet, maybe the ball that didn't become, let me think about it. Whee!